The Philadelphia Flyers fire coach Dave Hakstol. Just to be clear, not the GM, Ron Hakstol. He was fired, but like a couple weeks ago. This is their coach, Dave Hakstol. Moving on. Now, this whole thing, how we ended up here was strange because today's Monday, and over the weekend, there was a false report going on around how Philly had fired the coach, Dave Hakstol, then, not today, but then, and had also replaced him with Joel Quennville, formerly of the Chicago Blackhawks. Now, Fox Sports jumped on this first, contacted Quennville, and he denied it right away. He denied he ever talked to Philly at all. And then a report came out on in the Score, I want to say, in which they had spoken to Philly, and Philly said, Dave Hakstol is our coach. And we haven't even contacted Chicago about Joel Quennville. Because if any team is interested in signing Quennville as a coach, because he's still under contract to the Blackhawks, they have to ask Chicago's permission first. Yada, yada, yo. Yeah, and then all of a sudden, you know, and Hakstol gets fired this morning. That, you know, that news comes out. And that old report about, you know, Dave Hakstol is our coach disappears off the Score's news page, which I found, you know, a little weird. So, I mean, first the facts. Scott Gordon is going to, he's going to be the interim head coach. I believe he's the assistant coach with them. He's going to remain as a as the head coach for the rest of the season, as stated by the Philadelphia Flyers. As interim head coach, excuse me. And over that time, just look over Hakstol's numbers. He was like 134, 101, and 42 or something. That was his record over 4 years. He made the playoffs 2 times in those years, and they were eliminated in the first round each time. This year, Philly has just been awful defensively, especially in the last 10 games. They're now in the bottom of the league. They have in the Eastern Conference, excuse me, I want to say with like 28 points. And they've been losing games like 6-1, 6-0, 5-1, 4-1. It's just been yee. And we all know that the Flyers have not had stable goaltending, really, since Ron Hakstol was playing goalie for them back in the 80s, 90s. And so it's just been a turnstile of, you know, who's next kind of thing. But it's hard. It's, you know, Hakstol's defensive coverage, and not just for the defensemen themselves, but for, you know, for the forwards coming back to help, was just awful. It was, so never mind the goaltending. I mean, it's hard. It's hard to blame, you know, the goaltending on the coach, right? When you have you can't get him a decent goaltender. I mean, also what happened today, I feel I have to mention that Leon was just sent down, was just loaned to the AHL affiliate, the Phantoms, and because Stolaraz has gone on the IR for 2 to 4 weeks, apparently with a lower body injury, and so they recalled Carter Hart. Carter Hart, if you don't know, was a world junior champion gold medalist and silver medalist, and he's won all sorts of accolades in the WHL, the Western Hockey League. So far, this was his first year in the AHL, and he hasn't had the most spectacular record. I think it's like 9-5-2 or something, and his goals against his save percentage is like just over 900. I think his goals against is just over 3. But in his last 5 games down there in the AHL, he's been on fire. He's had like a 939 save percentage, a goals against under 2, and he's been playing really well. So, you know, I'm sort of scared for him, you know, because of the Flyers' lack of team defense, really, in a whole. Is bringing him up here and then he just gets shelled, is that going to be, you know, good for his confidence, for his growth? But if you feel, what else do you do? I mean, The only guy you can throw in there right now is Nerverth, I believe. So, because Elliott's still injured as well. I guess it's just a lack of choice. So, I mean, why not? Give him a shot, see what happens. But I would not keep him in there and throw him and just let him get shelled night after night after night if that's what starts to happen. Because that's, you know, that's not what, he's still pretty young. I want to say 20-ish, 19, 20. But I digress. Back to the whole, you know, the coach firing of Dave Hakstol, and Philadelphia saying they haven't even talked to Chicago about Quennville. It would be a PR campaign if they now ended up saying, oh, yeah, Quennville is our new coach. You know, it would be very strange. A lot of, you know, they'd be bombarded with a lot of questions, being like, okay, so you denied what happened on the weekend was had any truth to it, both of you, in fact, but the next day, not all, that the whole thing comes true. That's kind of weird. So either way, you know, let's say they are interested in Quennville, which, I mean, who wouldn't be, really, especially if you're in the position they're in. They're like, you know what, we got to wait till the off season, or at least wait a few months, you know, until we make a change like this. If I'm Fletcher, I'm like, you know what, let's just go for a high, you know, draft lottery pick. Maybe, you know, have a bit of a fire sale. You know, Simmons can go, etc. See what you can get for him. Maybe some of the older players, except for maybe your key core. The problem is you have like Giroux and Couturier. Giroux's on the wrong side of 30, I believe, and Couturier is close to 30. You have a really, you know, Provorov and the Ghost, Gostisbehere, on defense. They're really skilled, very young though. So you have this sort of mishmash of ages in the Philly lineup, and Hart, you would think, would need at least a couple, you know, another year or two marinating in the AHL, you know. But, you know, we'll see what happens to him here. In any case, I think I've been rambling on for too long now. What do you think is going to happen with Philly, with this coaching position? Are they going to wait to the end of the season and then do it? Who would you like to see behind the bench? Who do you think might be behind the bench? What moves do you think Fletcher is going to make now with these players? You know, is he going to start the fire sale? Probably not before Christmas. I believe the 19th is the cutoff, which is like 2 days from now. So maybe he'll wait till after the Christmas break or the All-Star break and start seeing what the market is like for some of the players he wants to get rid of. Who do you think those players might be? What do you think he gets rid of? And what do you think he wants back? So I'd love to hear what you'd have to say. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button. If you like this video, smash that subscribe button if you haven't already. And if you know any hockey geeks, please don't feel shy about sharing. Thanks again. I'll see you soon.